Hello everyone, myself Chahil sir from St. Joseph English Medium High School, Vijaipur. Today we are going to discuss a new chapter. The name of the chapter is Coordinate Geometry. As the name suggests, geometry, it belongs from the geometry chapter which has 4 marks. First of all, we'll try to understand the introduction. What is the meaning of the coordinate geometry? Coordinate geometry, it is a branch of mathematics in which we will discuss about the pair of points. The pair of points, in the sense, you need to understand the concept of Cartesian coordinates. Here, this is called as origin. Remember, always the origin is denoted by capital O, which will be here. And you know, in every graph, there will be two axes. One is called as a x-axis and another is called as a y-axis. You can see, this is the Cartesian plane and it has 4 quadrants. Quadrant first, quadrant second, third quadrant and the fourth quadrant. You know very well, suppose if we are measuring or we are defining any point, we will measure from x-axis as well as from y-axis. Together it is called as a coordinate points. Let me draw. Suppose if I draw here and up to here, this point is our coordinate points P of xy. This I will name it as M and this I will name as N. Now, if any distance of coordinate point P of x measured from y-axis, try to understand, this is the y-axis. We have to measure from y-axis, that is from O to M. So this will become our x distance. And this is called as abscissa. Remember this. Many times it has been asked in your examination. Abscissa. What is that? The distance of coordinate point P of xy from y-axis, which is denoted as x, and call it as abscissa. Similar, any distance which is measured from x-axis of a coordinate point P of xy, that is called as, denoted as y, and it is called as ordinate. So these two questions have been repeated in your examination several times. Let me revise once again. The distance of P of xy from x-axis is called as a abscissa, and the distance of P of xy from y-axis is called as a ordinate. Now, after that, we are going to discuss about the distance formula. What is the distance formula? Suppose if you want to measure the distance of NP or OM, we'll have to use a formula. That formula I'm going to write here. See here, D is equal to square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. It is measured in units. Here the unit may be centimeter square or the unit may be meter square. So in general we will write as units. So this is, once again I repeat, D is equal to square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. On this basis we are going to solve few problems. In that, the first problem is this type. Example number 1. The question will be like this. Find the distance between the points 6, pi and 2, comma 1. Whenever these kind of the questions will be there, will be usually for 2 marks. What we people have to do it? Let me run this. Here the question is, the given question is, find the distance between the points 6, 5, 2, 1. Once this type is given, we have to write 6, 5, 2, 1. The first pair of points will be always, one point will be x, another point will be y. Similar, here also one point will be x, another point will be y. So this we will denote as x1, y1, x2, y2. Always, in a coordinate point, the first point will be x-axis and the second point will be as y-axis. Now write the formula d is equal to square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Now I am going to substitute the given values. You can observe x2, what about the x2 here? 2 is there, minus x1 is 6 whole square plus y2 is 1 minus y1 is 5 whole square. Next we have to proceed. See here, d is equal to square root of, actually it is 2 minus 6, so it gives us minus 4 square plus 1 minus 5 gives us minus 4 square again. Further, d is equal to square root of minus 4 square is always plus 16 plus here again minus 4 square is plus 16. So this gives us d is equal to square root of 32, 16 plus 16. That further we can split like this, 16 2's are, and square root of 16 is nothing but 4 root 2 units. So this is the solution for question number 1. Thank you. Hello everyone, we are continuing the part distance formula. Already we have discussed one problem. We are proceeding to the second problem. The second problem you can see here, 2, 3, 4, 1 is there. When the points are given, I told you first of all write the coordinate points as x1, y1, x2, y2. Once you write like this, write down the formula, distance formula d is equal to square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. This is nothing but the distance formula to find the distance between the coordinate pair of points. Once you write like this, we have to proceed it further. D is equal to square root of, you can observe here, the x2 is nothing but 4, right here, 4 minus of x1 is nothing but 2 whole square plus y2. What about the y2? Y2 is 1. So 1 minus of y1 is nothing but 3 whole square. Further simplification is this time, d is equal to square root of, never forget to write under square root, this total problem is under square root, 4 minus 2 gives us 2 square plus 1 minus 3, actually here 3 has minus sign, so it will become minus 2 square. Next one is d is equal to square root of 2 square, you know 2 square is 4, plus of minus 2 square is also plus 4. If I solve this, 4 plus 4 is nothing but 8. This is not the final answer. This A, further you have to split like this. 4 2's are. Now, D is equal to, we know 4 is a perfect square. So, square root of 4 is nothing but 2 root of 2 dash dash units. Compulsory, you have to write the units because the distance are measured either in centimeter or meter. But here, particular unit has not given. So, in general, we have to write as units. So, this was the second problem regarding distance formula. The another problem is there, which looks like little different, but it is not different. Actually, it is based on distance formula only. When the points are given similar way, like this, we have to mark as x1, y1, x2, y2. After that, again write the distance formula which carries half marks. If you forget to write the distance formula, you will lose the half marks. Now, x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Once you write like this, again initiate with the given things. X2, what about the x2? Minus a, minus of, what about x1? That is also a whole square plus y2. Y2 is nothing but minus b, minus of, what about the y1? Y1 is here, that is b whole square. Next, if you see here, d is equal to square root of minus a gives us minus 2a whole square. It is just like minus 2 minus 2 minus 4. Similar way, minus a gives us minus 2a whole square. What is the sign here? Plus sign is there. So again write minus b minus b minus 2b whole square. The next is b is equal to square root of, you can observe, first of all it has two things, one number, one variable. So we have to do both the square, minus 2 square 4, and a square is a square. Plus similar way, minus 2 square is there, that is nothing but 4, and b square. We need to take the common here. You can observe easily, 4 is a common. So 4, if I suppose take common, inside what will remain? A square plus b square. Now square root of 4, as you know that 2. So 2 inside of the bracket, a square plus b square dash dash in units. We can't take the square root of this one because it is not in the proper identity. So this is the final answer. I hope you understood. One problem I'll give as homework, you try it at home. That I write here 6, minus 1, minus 5, minus 2. Hope you understood. Thank you.